Hi everybody, welcome to HDpiano, this is Joe, with a new one, The Ecstasy of Gold by Ennio Morricone. A classic track, amazingly symbolic in terms of its importance, and one of my faves. This is section one, here we go. Alright, there we have it. So, we're playing in the key of A minor. So the key signature has zero sharps or flats, that always helps. This is middle C, by the way. Question for you, which football or soccer World Cup did Ennio Morricone write the official theme tune for? Which was it? Anyway, so, we start here. We're playing in A minor, unsurprisingly. We're centered around A minor. Left hand, A octave there. Hold on to that for 8 beats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this hand, slightly harder. These are all 16ths. So imagine we're going very slow at the pace I'm currently at. All right, and what am I doing there? You're playing a 7th on B. And this note here, really, if you can do it, play it louder. You need to hold this on for the whole of the next two bars. So it's physically impossible, so you need to use the pedal, okay? And you play that 7th, that's the first 16th of the bar. And the second 16th, you jump down, finger 5, finger 3, finger 1. And that's the second inversion shape of A minor, the key chord. So. That is hard. You're moving like almost an entire octave. Very quickly, like that. That's what it is eventually. But for now, just practice that 7th on B and then finger 5 to C. Like that. And your finger 4 plays B and then more of that same second inversion A. B, second inversion A. B, second inversion A. So let's do that again. So B7, B7, second inversion A. And you basically do that, not just for this one bar, which is just ended, but also for another bar. All blurring together. And then you change. So again, B7 with A octave. 3, 4, next bar, 1, 2, final beat, 4. So at proper speed now. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you do it again. This time your left hand jumps over and plays E. So go like this on beat 2. 1, 2, like that. That E. So medley's like this. Okay, but of course we're playing the 7th as well to thicken it up. So 7th on B octave, 16th, A second inversion, left hand to E. The quicker you can do that crossover, the better. So, actually, I didn't think about that. So, rather than. Then you've got much more chance of missing the note, okay? Like that. Again. One more time. And you finish off the rest of the bar just like that. Just more of these notes. I think of these as like a horse just cantering along. Because there's galloping later that's not quite the same. And of course, this film, this music accompanies The Good, the Bad and the Ugly. A film that has lots of horses in it. Anyway, after done that bar, which was just done there, I'll do it at the proper speed. We go C octave here. And we move up to second position shape in the right hand of C major, but with our finger four, aware that we're going to be playing that note again, which, by the way, both times we've played that note, B and A, and D and C, it's the ninth note. So we're just playing like the ninth of C major in a way. Okay? That again. Again. Now we carry on this C theme for the next bar, but now the left overtakes over the clip clopping of the horse's hooves, like that. Okay, right hand's doing this melody right up here. So what do? We play G in the right hand and C9 in the left hand. But then our left hand needs to quickly shuffle up one place to get to that second position C shape there. Like that. This time there's 6 beats in the bar. So you play for a further 2 beats. Okay? So, 1, 2. And I'm gonna speed up a bit. 3, 4, 5. 6. One more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I mean, that corporate chord change there, just that is why I love music, I think. Just out of nowhere. It's actually not in the same key, of course. It's got an F sharp. So he decided to go out of key there and play what could only be described as perfection. So what am I doing there? D root 5 root in the left hand and a D first position chord here. All together on beat 1. Properly showing strength. Beautiful. And then our right hand goes to D here, and this. I'm not going to bother counting it out, you just have to copy it. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Again. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Proper speed. Next bar. Another classic chord, this time F octave down here and a very nicely spread F first position chord with an A doubled up on top. And there you gotta do sort of a bit of a unofficial fingering where 5 again like that, okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4 and that's what we do there. 1, 2, 3, 4 E's. And that's like the end of the first phrase, I suppose. 3, 4. Proper speed. I should just go from the D bar, just because it's so nice. 3, 4. And then back to. Okay, but this time, instead of there being 2 bars of this introduction, there's only 1. Which will catch you out, because then you're straight back into the thick of it now. With that same bars that we had earlier. Apart from now, instead of going... Sorry, what am I doing? That's it. and then to C, like we did in the first instance. Now we go to G, so it's like this. So seventh. It's actually easier to go from A to G because it's just next door. So everything moves down one. And you get this lovely G9. For actually three bars, we remain in G9 for three bars, but this particular bar, or this theme, lasts one bar, like that. Three, four. Let's go from the A again. So we just had our one bar intro for this next phrase. And here comes melody, a bit earlier this time. Crossover. Now G, everything's down a step, so beautiful. This is tricky. You gotta do a G9 and that B. That's a lot of travel, look at my hands. So this is where I've just finished up. That is a leap of faith, okay? So really, I found G9 I have no problem getting towards, is the B. So it might be worth having a little peek, a moment just before. So having a think about it now. Okay, now I'm going to B, so just had a look, there's B. And you've got a much higher chance of not splashing that note. Okay, again. Two, three, four. There we are. It's a big distance of travel. So it's exactly the same as that C9 bar in the left hand, apart from we're now not in C, we're in G. And actually I found that playing that and then just considering you're only moving up a step. Don't let your hand think you're going further, because it will, because your right hand is going way further. So it will just drag it with it. You don't need to be dragged with it, just only a step. Okay? And you'll probably start figuring out this pattern as soon as 9 second inversion chord, 9 second inversion in reverse. That'll start clinging, and that makes it much easier. So, and here, it's just going B to G this time. B, G. And then after that, same as the previous bar, the first G9 bar, we just do that again. So like that difficult bar with the big open reach to B and G is bookended by quite simple G9 bars. Okay, so first one, then looking at the B, and then back down again. Almost at the end now, we go to C second position. And then that D melody has now, in a way, transposed into C. Like that, let's do that slowly. One, two, three, four. Again, one, two, three, four. One more time. And then proper speed. To the end. So C root, 5 root. These are all half notes. These are all minims, so 2 beats each. And then E, G, E, so the third, the fifth and the third note of a C major chord. Beautiful. And then E sus 4. Okay, it also includes, actually no it doesn't, pardon me. So it's E sus 4 with its B is your lowest note, so it's in a second position. But it's like a fourth of B with another fourth of B with an A put in for good measure. And that's the suspended fourth note. And what happens to suspended chords? They tend to resolve to the major or the minor, but here we go. So C, E sus 4, and then root 5 root E with first position E makes E major, and then on the final beat. So let's do that a few times. 1, 2, E sus 4, 4, E major, 6. Again. Carries on. Last time at proper speed. 2, 3. Right, let's hear it uninterrupted. Here we go. There we have it, people. The Ecstasy of Gold, Section 1 by Ennio Morricone. Anyway, this has been Joe at HDpiano. If you are on YouTube, then give us a comment, drop us a like, come on over and subscribe, and then check out the website. There's all sorts there, including all the remaining parts of this, which it gets better and better and better and better, this piece of music. I mean, that section is amazing, but it gets better, believe it or not. So, this has been Joe, HDpiano. Thanks, guys. See you on the next one.